And here's Bob doing a little test dig on the side of a bank. Just showing, he'll show you a little bit on taking a test and sluicing it out. This is exactly what you do if you want to kind of find out what's in your pan. And it's amazing if there's a flake of gold in there so small that you can't see it, it'll be on the bottom. And here's Bob. This is when you get through with the pan. Here's how you really pan gold. That's a D9 shoving into some sluice boxes. Instead of standing there with a little pan, those are all pans of gold going in there, or gravel. They run through these sluice boxes at amazing rates. Whole loads of gravel goes through here in just seconds. Anyway, this is basically a placer mine. And this is Bob Young from Talkeetna in his younger days. Of course, we were all younger then. And this was Bob's first big cat. This did a lot of work for him. He had it for many years. He's had to replace a lot of things on it. I'm sure if Bob was here, he could tell us a lot more. Here, once you shove all that gravel through the sluice box, and it jams up at the end of the boxes. And you have to then move it away. This is what they call the tailing piles. You move this all away so that the water can come down through there, and so you can shove some more in. And the cats working in water like this all day long and stuff, it's hard on them. It's hard on the tracks. It's hard on the rear ends. If anything gets water in it, then it does. But this is mining the way you mine. Now here we are. This is the day of reckoning. Once every few days, you stop all operations. Stop the water. There's a gate up above, and you stop the water from coming through. You divert it around. And then you start cleaning your boxes. Now these big screens is what lets all the gravel and stone go across it, and only the very heaviest thing starts falling through. And on the very bottom, you have rugs. And this is Bob cleaning and shaking out the rugs and letting just a little bit of water through. You can start to see the gold starting to show up. And here's where you have to be very meticulous. Every shovelful of dirt now might contain a lot. There you're looking at many ounces of gold there. And Bob, he was a Pepsi man. This would be a good advertisement for Pepsi. Because Pepsi was the only thing there ever was, and I kind of agree with Bob, pretty good. Anyway, this is Bob showing you some gravel, and he's showing you some nuggets. Pieces of that size are considerable. I have no way of judging today. But that pan right there, right now, contains thousands of dollars by today's prices. I don't know. Back then, Bob was selling gold all the way from $35 an ounce to maybe $60 or $70 an ounce. But anyway, I happened to be where one time when Bob sold 100 ounces of gold for $800 an ounce. That's when gold hit its very high point,